Books are thin, books are fat, books are thick, books are flat. Some books are classic, others are dumb. There's one on every subject under the sun. William Shakespeare, Harry Potter, written by Mrs. Rowling's daughter. Philip Roth, Dr. Seuss, E.B. White, and Marcel Proust. Now science courses, books on horses, B-books, tree books, all for you. Mysteries and histories, who done it, how to do it, why they do it, what they do. Oh, Holden Caulfield, Nancy Drew, Long John Silver, and Tarzan too. I love Captain Underpants and the Hunchback of Notre Dame. From France, astrology, astronomy, books on World Wars 1 and 2. There are politics and parlor tricks. Who done it, how to do it, why they do it, what they do. Shel Silverstein and Oscar Wilde, Henry James and Julia Child, Maurice Sendak, Caleb Carr, and the rest, well, they know who they are. Some books have pictures, others don't. Some you'll get, and others you won't. Some books are boring, but most are fun. There's one on every subject, including the sun. Who done it, how to do it, why they do it, what they do. Ooh!
Hi, I'm Janet Dymond, Library Director. I'm here to update you on a couple of areas of the library. Our children's room is currently undergoing a rearrangement and redecoration. So this weekend, the friends came in and we swapped some bookcases around. The tall bookcases from the children's room were moved into the art room, and the shorter bookcases in the art room were moved into the children's room. This will make it a little bit easier for children to reach the books, and all the shelves are matching in that area now. Next weekend, we plan to begin again rearranging more shelves, and we'll start hopefully adding some furniture, a couple of desks to accommodate the new computers, which we have 2 new desktops and 2 tablets for the children's area. Michael Hunt will speak more on this later on in the video. Also, I want to talk about a new service that the library is just launching. We are now going to be offering homebound delivery services. There is an application which will be available online. It's a very simple application. All you have to do is be a resident of the town of Woodstock and have some difficulty getting to the library. It could be short-term, maybe you know, a broken leg, or more long-term where it's difficult for you to leave your house. So we do have a very simple application. We are partnering with the Friends of the Library, so we're offering 2 different options. You can receive books from the book sale, and you would just have an exchange program that the Friends would bag up the books, bring you books on a topic of interest to you, and then when you're done with that, you would contact the library, and we would pick those up and bring you a different bag of books. We also have the option of actually borrowing library materials. We currently have 2 volunteers that have agreed to deliver materials to houses of individuals that sign up for this program. We are always looking for more volunteers, so if this is a program you're interested in helping with, you're welcome to come to the library and volunteer your time as well. We're hoping to reach more people and provide more library service with this program. You can call the library for more information. And we hope to serve you in ways that we haven't been able to before. Thank you.
Hello, everyone. I'm Doris Goldberg, president of the Woodstock Public Library. And I'd like to tell you about what the board is currently working on and excited about. We are in process of interviewing 6 architectural firms in order that we can choose one to create a master plan that is going to consider the entire facility and our needs as well as wishes for a future period of time. How long into the future is difficult to say, but it's going to need to be flexible space because we can't always foresee all of the things that we will want to do. We've been very lucky in having 18 firms actually answer our request for proposal that was put out. And from these 18, we have narrowed it down to 6. And we're very hopeful that we can get a firm that is going to be able to do the job for Woodstock. The job for Woodstock will involve going to community to get more current information than we've obtained. We've obtained a lot of information, and most recently it's been the library survey that Janet Dymond has put out and had analyzed. But we will get even more current information and tap in as widely as we can to different groups in the community about their use of the library and what they want from the library and what they hope from the library. And after doing this, the architects will create different options for us, whether it will be renovating and building on to our existing library, or it will involve some other configuration. But then they will come back and we will have public meetings and a chance for community to react to the different options that will also have costs attached to them. Costs not only of the building, but of maintenance. So we really hope for a thorough and careful job being done by the firm and also seeking input from the community. And at that point, we will have a better idea of what our next step should be.
Hi, this is Michael Hunt, Vice President of the Friends of the Woodstock Library. And I'm here in the children's room with our new computers and tablets for the children of the Woodstock Library. We like to think of ourselves, the Friends, as a wish fulfillment committee. The library staff and the director wish for things to make this a better learning environment for everyone, and then we fulfill those wishes. And at the same time, we give the taxpayers of Woodstock a little break. And this is a long time coming, but these computers that you see, these desktops and these tablets, are digital learning solutions. They are filled with educational games, math, science, social studies, map reading, music, culture. They're filled with learning games, and they are not connected to the internet. They're not wireless. They are going to be stationed here in the kids' room at the Woodstock Library for, the desktops are for pre-K through third grade, and the tablets are a little more advanced. They're like grades 1 through 4. So it's really elementary school learning. And we think they're going to go, well, they've already started beautifully here with the kids, seem to respond. We have no instruction book to take out. We just turn them on and let the kids start playing. And, of course, intuitively, they got the hang of it pretty quickly, and we're learning their ABCs and their 1, 2, 3s. And it's just a nice complement to this room, which the Friends, in partnership with the library director and the staff, we're going to make this room over. To make it a little more efficient, make the have room for these new computers to fit, and we're going to create a dedicated space for the older kids, older than these things, the preteen and teen, and make sure that they know in this community they have a place dedicated to them at the library for studying and research and everything you're going to do here in this wonderful library. So look in the near future. Sneak a peek and see our progress, and by May 21st, we're going to have a gala reopening of this room where kids can come in and play with these computers and test them out and try out the new and improved, lean, mean, more efficient children's room of the Woodstock Library. Thank you.
My name is Bob Lavaggi, and I've lived in Woodstock for 45 years and have always loved the whole existence of the library, including the books and the events around the library and the library fair. I'm dyslexic, which means that I personally don't enjoy reading, but I do read nonfiction when I need information, and I have done lots of research in the library. On the other hand, my wife loves reading. She reads with passion, and the library, the Woodstock Library, keeps her well stocked in books that she continually reads. In fact, at night she reads when we go to bed and sometimes reads to me. So I get a lot of information from the library via Deborah, my wife. Barry Miller offered me this opportunity to talk to you about the book that I recently wrote, called Primal Economics. And here's the book, Primal Economics. Having written the book, I discovered that economics is not a hot item. People are not really interested in economics, which was a surprise to me because it seems so key to our general condition and well-being. I got involved in or interested in the subject because of economic inequality and trying to get a grasp of why it is that there are sectors of the population that are super wealthy while sectors are live in poverty. And I wanted to explore that whole question for myself. I began writing essays that led to this book. Generally, people who are wealthy are inclined to sit within the ethics of ownership integrity, and people on the other end of the economic spectrum live more in the notion of sharing and greater well-being. Ethics and economics are two separate things. Ethics has to do with the way people treat each other, and economics has to do with the way people deal with each other to get what they want. That distinction was very useful for me to come to terms with. The other thing which was very compelling to me was the whole system of economics that is set up in this country, whereby the wealthiest people really control the structure that money and economics lives in. The wealthiest members of our economic community have it worked out so that they keep us in debt. They have excess money they don't know what to do with. They are inclined to lend it to the population at large and the government. And that money gets circulated for a while until it ends up back in their pockets as interest on their loans. And really, they are in control of our economic condition, much the same as the kings were 300 years ago. Instead of paying taxes to the king, we pay interest to the millionaire class. This is a condition which is complicated to solve, but I very strongly urge my readers in my book to avoid borrowing and getting into debt as much as possible, or perhaps only borrowing when you're borrowing to earn money, but to avoid borrowing for the sake of consumption. That probably is a quick synopsis of the book, Primal Economics, and my thanks to Barry for having this interview. My website is primaleconomics.info, where you can find out more about the book.
Sound of a train whistle as spoken by a guitar. The giddy sound of the southbound freight and the high-speed hum of the passenger train come a part of the soul and the heart and mind of the boy that's raised by the railroad line. The sound of the whistle in the crossing road, in the tanks and the trucks and the tractors on the flat car load, come a part of the soul and the heart and the mind of the boy that's raised by the railroad line. And the big round penny that you laid on the rails at the wheels smash flat, and a glimpse of the faces of the ladies and the man in the engineer hat, and the brakeman waves from the red caboose. He's a part of the past and never really broke loose. He's a part of the soul and the heart and the mind of the boy that's raised by the railroad line. That big round penny that you lay on the rails with the wheels flash flat, and a glimpse of the faces of the ladies and the man in the engineer hat. And his blows from the red caboose. He's a part of the past and never really broke loose. He's a part of the soul and the heart of the boy that's raised by the railroad line. The boy that's raised by the railroad.
Books are thin, books are fat, books are thick, books are flat. Some books are classic, others are dumb. There's one on on every subject under the sun. William Shakespeare, Harry Potter, written by Mrs. Rowling's daughter. Philip Roth, Dr. Seuss, E.B. White, and Marcel Proust. Now science courses, books on horses, bee books, tree books, all for you. Mysteries and histories, who done it, how to do it, why they do it, what they do. Oh, Holden Caulfield, Nancy Drew, Long John Silver, and Tarzan too. I love Captain Underpants and the Hunchback of Notre Dame. From France, astrology, astronomy, books on World Wars 1 and 2. There are politics and parlor tricks. Who done it, how to do it, why they do it, what they do. Shel Silverstein and Oscar Wilde, Henry James and Julia Child, Maurice Sendak, Caleb Carr, and the rest, well, they know who they are. Some books have pictures, others don't. Some you'll get and others you won't. Some books are boring, but most are fun. There's one on every subject, including the sun. Who done it, how to do it, why they do it, what they do. Ooh.